Brad Pitt is one of the few Hollywood heavyweights who's both an actor's actor.
The first rule of Fight Club is you do not talk about Fight Club.
And a bona fide movie star.
Immortality! Take it! It's yours!
Making one of the most memorable film debuts more than 30 years ago in Thelma and Louise.
I mean, you gotta give you something special. I think you ought to pass it on.
Brad's movie magic has seen him appear in some of the most iconic films in the last few decades.
Sound good?
Yes, sir!
That's what I like to hear.
The icing on the cake, an Oscar win in 2020 to the delight of fans around the world.
Once upon a time in Hollywood, he bet the truth.
Now he's starring in Bullet Train, directed by a guy Brad has a long screen history with.
We met years ago, he was my stunt double, now he's my boss.
Yep, David Leitch was Brad's stunt double in Fight Club and Troy, and is now responsible for directing him in a high-speed, heist-action film like no other.
What am I snatching and or grabbing?
A briefcase.
You said you wanted simple for your first job back.
You stab me?
There's nothing simple about this job.
Something else going on here.
Yeah, I'm not the only one on this train looking for this case.
Gentlemen, welcome to the project. Great to have you with us. Congratulations on Bullet Train, by the way. I don't know how to describe this film. It is an outrageous amount of fun. There is so much chaos. Brad, when you're filming something like this, is it as madcap and harebrained to make as it is to watch?
yeah, a little bit. You know, I think this script came along and the project came along in the heart of lockdown. At that point when we were all going a bit stir crazy and really questioning our life and our choices and our existence. And did we even want to be here? You know, it got dark. And then the script came along and it was so damn funny.
Eat a bag of d***s, lady. I'm sorry. I'm working on it.
It had all great parts in it. So you knew we were going to get a great, great cast that we're going to run with it. Actually, I think we were really fortunate to have that kind of outlet in that moment of darkness. And to be able to go on this set, we had to shoot it all on a soundstage, which is a feat in itself. And the actors are hilarious. And so it was pretty maniacal.
And the aesthetic of it too, David, it's very Japanese, which is part of this sort of East Asian look and feel that we're starting to see a lot more in the West, but is still new and a bit exciting to us. And of course, there's this bonkers tradition of Japanese television. Were you leaning into that?
All of those little things are touchstones. Like, I love hard-boiled, genre cinema from Japan, from Korea. Like, I love that stuff, you know? So we had some of that ultra violence in there, and to make it slightly heightened so we could go on this journey and accept the absurdity and enjoy it, as opposed to, if I think if we grounded it so much, all the weird, unbelievable things just aren't as enjoyable because you're like, what? But in this world, you're like, cool, right? And so that's, we put that all in the pot.
Ooh, David Lee. That's about to be sick, man.
Brad, your character Ladybug is a unique one. I don't think I've ever seen an assassin before who goes around chanting personal growth mantras to themselves.
That was so damn funny to me. This idea that again, maybe this parallels where we were at that time, because, you know, a lot of us were really questioning our how we were living our life, you know, how we were just the grind. People were selling homes and getting camper vans and, you know, taking off in the country. So I like the idea of this guy who maybe he's coming off a breakdown. We don't know. Whatever it is, it's a hiatus. He's had a couple of months of therapy. He's read a self-help book and he's had a couple of epiphanies and he thinks he's on his way, and that he's going to be able to deal with these sociopaths and assassins in a different way, you know, through conflict resolution and a win-win situation for everyone. And of course, that doesn't bode well.
You want to talk this out?
Not particularly, no.
Okay.
It's a hilarious idea, but it also strikes me as a risky one. Like, it could easily not have worked. Like, at what point did you look at it and go, yes, this is working?
When you have someone who's so good at building characters like Brad is, like, you take all those gems that are instinctual that he's bringing, and then we just build on them. And when the crew is laughing and the crew is like, I mean, you know, like, they're loving this sort of platitudes that he's preaching, and they're offering ones that they have from their own self-help. Like, people were pitching platitudes. It was pretty funny.
Brad, luck is a very big theme in your character's story arc. Would you say, looking back on your career, that you've been a little luckier than Ladybug?
Well, Ladybug, oh my God, he just can't get out of his own way, can he? He's such a chump. Which I can relate to. I think we all relate to a little bit. But I would say fortunate. I would certainly say fortunate. But, you know, in the film, I think we're trying to say to Ladybug, you know, it's perspective. And now I sound like a self-help book again, don't I?
Without giving too much away, though, one of the interesting features of your character is his touching affection for Japanese toilets. Do you feel the same way?
Yes, I would say that I'm pretty firm on this belief that toilet paper is an antiquated concept.
Yes.
It's draconian. I don't know why we're satisfied with this. So I'm really impressed with the smart toilet, the Japanese toilet, and thank God someone was thinking for all of us.
Well, I think it's only fair that we finish this interview on the toilet.
Yeah. As we all do. Sooner or later.
Indeed. Words to live by. David, Brad, thanks so much for joining us on the project. Great to talk.
Thank you. Thanks much.
Thank you.
I'm with Brad. I've been to Japan 10 times. Right. Toilets are fantastic.
Is that what you took out?
Toilets are unbelievable. I know a mate who loved them so much he imported one and installed it in his bathroom.
I think you might like this film, Pricey. The toilet's a bit of a star in it. So
fabulous.
It is an incredibly fun film. Bullet Train speeds its way into cinemas this Thursday, August the 4th.